I wanted to talk a little bit more about fats and our food. Some of us have a dim view of fat and feel like it's all probably bad. But remember that lipids have important roles in cellular biology and in how the overall organism functions. And so we need to look at what some of the different kinds of fats are and see what's really important and what we don't want as much of. So there's something called an essential fatty acid, and these are the fatty acids we need to build true fats that our bodies can't build on our own. And so we need to get these fatty acids from our food, and it's really important to get that. Those are things like omega-3s and omega-6s, and you often hear about food supplements that will have omega-3s and omega-6s in them. Often fish oil is something that will contain those. But you can also get them directly from fish, especially an oily fish like salmon. You can also get them from various vegetables and nuts. And it is important to have those in your diet. And I always like to mention they're especially important in developing brains. We need those fatty acids for kids as they're growing. So if you can mix in a serving of salmon a week for kids, that can be really, really healthy and important for them. The other thing I want to mention is saturated fats, unsaturated fats, and trans fats. And so not all fats are created equal. And here we have a picture of the three different kinds. So notice all three of these have the long carbon backbone with the attached R group. And they're all basically the same, but this one's got some double bonds, and this one has one double bond. So a saturated fat is just one that has no double bonds. It has all hydrogens bonded to single carbons and carbons bonded to carbons. And what this means is at room temperature, if you have many of these together, they can easily lie on top of each other, and so they're found in a solid form. And so this is what butter is made of primarily. Unsaturated fats mean they have one or more double bonds, and these double bonds create a physical kink in this backbone chain. And you can imagine if you had many of these laying on top of each other, they wouldn't lay quite so nicely. They would bump around, and because of that, at room temperature, these guys will be a liquid. And so this is what olive oil, canola oil, all the vegetable oils would be. So now let's fast forward to the human body. If this molecule is floating around and it can pile on top of itself, it can actually cause plaques in your system. Where if you've got these double bonds, it's less likely to start to plaque up and cause problems in your arteries. And that's why vegetable oil is considered healthier than butter because it doesn't form as many plaques. Now, there's a third kind out there which is called trans fat. And trans fat is where you have only one or two double bonds. But the way that this was formed is this kind of vegetable oil was taken through a chemical process where it was slammed with hydrogens using a lot of energy, and those hydrogens were added chemically rather than naturally. And it creates something called a trans double bond. Now, notice at this double bond, both hydrogens are sticking up. That's a cis double bond. Down here, where this is a man-made double bond rather than a naturally occurring one, now your hydrogens are transverse. So you have one poking up, one poking down. And that seems like a pretty subtle difference and not a big deal. But here's the problem. In our bodies, we have the enzymes or the molecular scissors that can happily cut this, no problem. Turns out, if your hydrogens are like this, we don't have the scissors to cut this apart. So, here's the problem with trans fats. We don't have the enzymes to break them down, so when you eat them, they stay in your system for a really long time. And in this case, I said, oh, this is going to build up in your bloodstream. It's eventually going to get taken up into different cells where this is going to stay in your bloodstream much longer. So, trans fats actually are the worst thing for you. And you might ask, why would we make these man-made fats that are not at all good for you? And the reason is they help food have a long shelf life. Just like we don't have the enzymes to break this down, most bacteria or fungi don't either. So the reason a Twinkie can sit on the shelf for 10 years is because it's made of these kinds of fats. These kinds of fats will go rancid eventually. They'll break down where these will last a long time. So we can ship foods for a long time, we can store them for a long time, but they're not nearly as healthy for us. The new labeling guidelines are starting to show trans fat versus unsaturated fat versus saturated fat. This is the ideal for us to consume, and of course, all things in moderation. And in fact, the last part of your packet shows a label for some yummy potato chips. Take a look and see if you can identify all those different components of food and if you can identify the different kinds of fat in there. And that is a brief summary of biomolecules and the basic chemistry of life.